Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. So I'm getting lots of requests that we are getting errors that we are not having the region name configured or we have not configured the AWS credentials. So this video is all about that. So that error can be resolved by installing the AWS CLI, right? There is another way by which you can resolve this issue. So that is, while having your coding, you just need to configure your AWS credentials like your secret key and access key. So that can be defined into your while getting the object of your client or resource of S3 or any of other AWS services. The second way, if you don't want to every time just configure or mention all your credentials, you just need to configure into your system. And that can be only happen by using the AWS CLI. So this is the official page from where you can install the AWS CLI. So for Windows, this is the link to download the installer. For Mac OS, this is the link, and for Linux and for Amazon Linux also. So I have Mac OS, so I'm going to download this installer and I have already downloaded it. So let me show you that. So here it is. It is of 21.5 MB. So what I need to do, I just need to click on it and I'm going to install it. So here it is. And what you need to do, you just need to by default, just click on the things, right? Agree, continue, continue and continue. So I have already installed it. So I'm not going to reinstall it, right? So I'm going to just close this. So this is the thing by which you can install the AWS CLI. Now come to how you can configure these things. So for that, I need to open the terminal. And after installing the AWS CLI, what you need to do, you need to just, okay, so let me show you the help command first. So if you enter the AWS help and enter, and these are the commands. Let me just maximize it. Yeah. So if you see here, all the help are here, right? So if we go from up, so name AWS, then description is here. The AWS command line interface is a unified tool to manage your AWS services, right? And what you need to do, you just need to use AWS. Then you need to have options like debug, endpoint, URL, then command, then subcommand, then parameters. So for now, I'm just going to show you how you can configure your AWS credentials so that you don't need to configure all the times in your code or to get rid of that error where you are getting region name not defined or credentials are not mapped with your system, right? So I'm going to exit it. So we are back to the AWS, right? So what I need to do, what command I need to type here. So I'm typing AWS configure. That's it. So this is the command. Now you need to hit enter. So after hitting the enter, if you have configured previously your credentials, then you will get this kind of format. So where you will have your previous key, right? So I have configured it. So if you have not configured, then you just need to paste your access key here, right? And then again hit enter. And here you need to paste your secret access key. And here you need to define your default region name. As here you can see, I have defined US East 2 region, right? And the last option which you will get, this is the default output format. So for now, I'm just going to keep it as blank, or you can also keep it as blank. I'll tell you about this option in my future videos. So if you have not defined here, then the default format will be as JSON, right? So, and then again hit enter. So this is it. So these are the four steps or four things, or basically minimum, at least you need to define three things, which is access key, secret key and the region name to get rid from those errors. Now I'm just going to give you a bit more idea why we are using this AWS CLI. Having this, I can access all my remote things which are deployed on AWS services or AWS cloud. Like right now, I'm going to access my S3 things, right? So for that, what I'm going to do, so AWS S3, and I'm going to here list all the buckets which I have on my S3. So ls for this, and here I'll have, okay, so I have error that an error occurred, invalid access key when calling the list bucket operation. So I need to define the access key here. So I'm going to configure that. So I'm going to skip that part from this video. So let me rerun that command. So that is AWS S3 and then we have ls, right? So now so I got three folders by the name try to cache glue and try to cache hosting testing, right? So friends, that's it for this video. I hope now you are able to understand why AWS CLI is necessary to configure into your system. In future videos, I'll tell you how you can access other services like S3, EC2 instance or DynamoDB things. That's it for this video. If you really enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon also. If you have any questions, please comment down in the comment section. Till then, thank you for watching. Jai Hind.